Today is July 13, 1998. We're interviewing Ella Davis. Name at birth was Vidic. Interviewer is Sheila Roden Novak. We're conducting the interview in Columbia, South Carolina, USA, and it's being conducted in English. My name is Sheila Roden Novak. We're interviewing Ella Davis in Columbia, South Carolina, on July 13, 1998. Ella, would you please tell us your name and spell it for us? Tell us your name.
Ella Davis, geborene Wittig.
And have you ever been known by any other names?
No.
And what is your birth date?
10/9/34.
And your current age is what? How old are you now?
64.
And what is the city and the country of your birth?
Stuttgart, Germany.
Ella, tell us a little bit about what kind of a child you were.
I was a little girl. I started going to school, and then they stopped me.
What are some of your best memories as a child?
Well, I was with my mother and my father in Karlsruhe. My father was in the army. This was my sister and brother was with me.
What is your father's name?
Albin Wittig.
And your mother's name?
Sophie Birkefelder.
And do you know how your parents met?
No, I don't know that.
How many sisters and brothers did you have?
I got 9. I just got 1 brother now.
And can you tell me all of their names?
Yes. The name was Popler. And then I came. And then Maria, Gisela, Kuno, and Florian.
And what kind of work did your parents do when you were growing up?
They buy stuff and sell it.
And did you work?
Yes, I did too. You get taught when you did it.
And what kind of work did you do?
I sell the stuff for door for door.
And what was your parents' national background? Your father?
My father was in the army, in the German army.
And was he German?
Yes.
And what religion was your father?
Catholic.
And what about your mother? What was her nationality?
She was Gypsy.
And what was her religion?
Catholic also.
And did you have a favorite toy growing up?
I had a bear.
And did he go everywhere with you?
Yeah, I took him everywhere.
What kind of things did you like to do as a little girl?
Play.
Did you have a lot of friends?
No. We never had no much friends.
What kind of a neighborhood did you grow up in?
In a normal neighborhood. Was normal.
Were there gypsies in that neighborhood?
Yes, it was.
And was there like a tribe?
You know, when you are gypsy, you got them trailers. And everybody had children, especially gypsies. They had a bunch of children. And we children met each other and we stayed together all the time. Because they got us. And this is the same. When they get you, you can play no more. is finished. You neither can go in school no more. Dina did nothing. And they took us from the school and you never go back no more. They just took you and put you away.
Before we talk about that, I want to know a little bit more about how you grew up, okay? Tell me about your grandparents.
Oh, he was nice.
Were these your father's parents?
Yeah, my mother's parents.
What were your grandparents' names?
My father, mother?
No, their parents.
Oh, I don't know that.
You don't know your grandfather's name?
No. Paul was him. And Olga. My dad isn't father, mother.
And what about your mother's?
Wilhelm. I don't know my grandmama's name no more.
And did you spend much time with your grandparents?
Yes, I did. My mama had so many children, so we all the time went to grandmother.
Do you have any special memories of your grandmother? Did she do something special for you?
Yeah, she did. She was in a circus. She had snakes around her neck.
Snakes?
Snakes, yeah. So I know she did special work. Work in a circus.
Were you afraid of the snakes?
No, I never was afraid. Now, yeah.
Did you see your grandmother in the circus ever?
Yeah, I did.
And what about your father's parents? What did they do?
They sell and buy. That's all what they did.
Was there a special food that your grandmother made?
Yeah, cookies and on. Baked potato pie, an onion cake. And we went all the time to her, but she baked all the time. She was a very nice lady.
Who did anybody else live with you when you were a child?
My sister.
Other than your immediate family?
No.
Did your family roam at all while you were growing up?
What she did?
Did they travel in a caravan at all?
No.
Did you have a regular house?
Yeah, regular house, apartment.
Did any of your family travel while you were growing up?
No.
And what language did you speak at home?
I speak Gypsy. And German.
And did you learn any other languages?
In the concentration camp, yes.
What languages did you learn?
Polish. No, by all the time we hang out by the Polish ladies, while they was by the kitchen working there. All the time we get some food there. So we was there all the time. And like, they had the food, and you talk to them. I learned bread, leber. This was what you learn. Dabei, go faster, and stuff like that. You learn easy there.
Going back to your childhood, tell me how your family celebrated holidays like Christmas. What was that like in your house?
This was okay. We get special food.
What kind of food?
I'm a noodle lady. I like noodles. And potato salad. And sauerkraut. Food like that. And then my mama cooked that special, that food.
And did you get presents?
Yeah, we got presents.
What kind of presents?
A doll or a dress, pair of shoes. We not got so much the playmate. Once in a while they give us a doll or something small.
Did a lot of people come over to your house for the holidays?
Yes. My uncles, my aunties.
What kind of stories were passed down in your family? Did you hear stories from
No.
Your mama didn't tell you
no,
stories?
No, she didn't tell us no stories.
And do you recall any special activities that you did with your gypsy relatives?
No.
Did you see yourself as German first or as gypsy first?
Als German. And then later, als gypsy, I mean I could go nowhere.
And what about your family? Did they all consider themselves Germans first?
No, gypsy.
And what about your father?
My father went German. My dad was in the army.
Did he identify with the gypsies, your father?
Yeah, I talked to them. My father now speaks a good gypsy. Our little bit at it. Learned from my mother. And we was talking then. My daddy no one that he talk me talk gypsy. Everyone hide it.
And what kind of a school did you attend?
In a normal school. I went in there. She got me out of school.
And what language did they speak in school?
German.
Were there other Roma and Sinti students in your school?
Yes, war in there.
Was it a mixed class?
Mixed class.
Do you remember any particular teachers?
No.
Nobody made a special impression?
No. Mm.
Did you have any experiences being registered or in a genealogical study by the Germans?
No.
Did somebody come into your school?
Yes.
And what happened?
This was civil people. They had civilian clothes on, but were our Nazis. And they took us out of school to make picture and fingerabdruck. You know them?
Fingerprint.
Yeah. And they make the pictures for us. And then they let us, they take us home. This was all. And they did it a couple days. Come in and go out, come in and go out. Take us out of school.
And did they do anything else on you?
No, they not did nothing. They definitely not did nothing. You just want us have. They want us that we go somewhere. I was scared then. And I was scared to tell my mother that. Weil my mama all the time raised then. Went in school in there and asked, why they do that? So, that was this was all. We see pick us up in the morning, 4 o'clock in the morning. And knock on the door, and they want us all out. My daddy and my mama, they was drive around first to town. And then they say, we shall get a regulation. This was probably was easy to get us. So all the gypsy stop, no move around no more. And for the house to stay there. And we went there. And then they had, they know everybody who was living gypsy. And they got us.
Before that happened, how were your relations, you and your family, with the Gadges? Did you have relations? Did you know them?
No.
Did your father work with some?
Yeah, my daddy was working with them.
Did they ever come into your home?
No. Mm-mm.
And what was the name of the leader of your gypsy group?
Oh, he died in the concentration camp. I had some with him stomach. I could just eat Milch und Weidbrett. And he died. My mama hit him on the head.
Who?
My mother. Well, she found out that they tell on us all.
Who told on you?
A gypsy man. I was thinking I can save himself when I tell on the people who was related with gypsies. So my mama found that out, and then she took her shoes and hit him on the head. I was bald-headed.
Was this in the camp?
No, this was outside, no.
Before the camp?
Yeah.
The gypsies that your mother belonged to, did they have a clan name or a tribe name?
No, just gypsy.
Was there a leader of that group? Somebody that they went to for decisions about things?
No. Mm-mm.
No leader of your mama's group?
No.
What kind of experiences do you remember of discrimination before the Nazis picked you up? This was one story. And what else? Any other stories you remember?
We was in the concentration camp then. And then they put all the people in the trailer, in the train. This was bad.
Before that, when you were still living at home, do you remember anybody doing bad things to you or to your family?
No. Just taking the picture and the thing up.
And?
They measure your face. They find it out what you are, gypsy or the German or the. They was looking for that. You did that.
Did anybody call you bad names?
No, they said gypsies, Zigeuner.
And did anybody get beaten up walking on the street or anything like
this? Oh yeah, the Jewish people. They beat them bad up, them people.
And what about your people?
Gypsies too, yeah. I was not that much. They had a thing on them. You see him from far away that they were Jewish. And the gypsies. They don't want no gypsies in there. They won't clean the people out.
Did you ever have to wear an armband or anything like that?
No, I had one in the concentration camp.
But before that, when
no,
you were on
I don't have to wear it.
Did you have to have an identification card? Something that said who you were?
No, I don't think so.
What about your mother?
My mama probably had one. I don't know. You need a paper. You need the pass. You know, the police and the Nazi were standing there somewhere. And then you have to show something that you can pass that way.
Did you have that kind of pass?
No.
But your mama did?
Yeah.
And do you remember not being able to do anything? Were you able to go to the park and play?
No. You could not go there. When they pick you up, you were scared. You don't want to go there no more. They pick you up anytime when they feel like. They hit you anytime when they feel like they hitting you.
Did this happen to you?
Yeah. When I went to my school.
What happened?
So you know, go there. When this happened to you, you know, you were scared. Right now, people are scared for that stuff. But you never know what's going on in the world.
And do you remember a week in 1938, when a lot of the gypsies were rounded up and their belongings were broken up and taken away and stuff. What happened then? Tell me about it.
You just break stuff and burn it. And then we gypsies, we start running to one corner, to the other corner, just a like a dog. You run there, run there, and run there. And it was just like a dog get you. That way the Nazi could try get you. And when they catch you, they put you in jail house and put you somewhere. And this, you all the time was scared. All the time. You no care. While this go around, people, they take it, people and put them away.
Do you remember seeing that happen?
Yeah, this happened. In the morning they came. 4 o'clock in the morning. Chase me with the truck. And take the people out of the house. Put on top of the truck and drive away.
Did this happen to people you knew?
Yeah. To my own auntie, they did that. And she went in that. In that. To the Polish people. In the, how you call it? I don't know how you say that now. Was no concentration camps, was nothing. Was just houses. They put them in there. And this was the last way how you go. They take you out then and put you to the concentration camp. There were the train get filled up, and this was the last way where you go. You could not go nowhere no more. How do you was lucky and got away? How if you got away, they get you anyway later on.
So you remember this week in 1938. Do you remember seeing things broken and so on?
Yeah, they call that Crystal Night.
And were the gypsies affected too?
Yeah, well, not that much like the Jewish people.
Did they do it before this to the gypsies?
I don't know that. Well, this was most of the time was for the Jewish people. This was the Crystal Night. They went in there and break everything and throw the books, the good books out and burn them. That's what he did. Our gypsy was not that much. They got them and put you away and this is it.
Did you have to report to the local police, your family?
Yes, they got to. You got to tell them where you live. You got to tell them where you stay, and thank you, and how many people stay there, and how many you know, and then they ask you, is there more gypsy there, and then they say, yeah, my cousin there, or then they pick them up later. So gypsy people not talk much.
Did you have to go to the police yourself at all?
Yeah, I met my mother, I went there.
And what happened to you there?
They just scare you. When they finish scaring you, then they let you go again. My mama took me then, we went home. Our, there were so many people in there, you could not see nothing no more. Everybody was howling and crying. But they know they don't come back no more.
Were you or anyone in your family ever arrested by the police? Were you in jail at all?
No, just when they got us. When they got us, they put us there. This was just like a house, no? You go in there and stay for 8 days. We still got time to put you to the concentration camp.
Was your whole family put into this?
Yeah.
So tell me what happened. How did they get your family together? What happened?
Early in the morning, 4 o'clock, the Nazi came and knocked at the door and tell them I want the gypsy woman with the children. My daddy say no. My daddy say I'm working for the people. I'm in the army, I fight for the country. And I don't give nobody out. And then they got them still out. So after that, my daddy may have to go too, while I take the picture down and drop it on the floor.
The picture of who?
Of the Hitler. And step on it, broke it. My daddy, I say, why I shall do that when I fight for the country? And I do stuff like that. So I break the picture with his feet. And then we went with the truck in jailhouse in Karlsruhe. And me and my mama and my brothers and sisters, we was in one jailhouse in there. And my father was in another room. And before my father left the house, I had his gun with him. And then where I was with the gun, I say, my children don't go nowhere. I try shoot us in the jailhouse. And my mama went on the knees and say, not do it. Not do it, Alvin. Leave it alone. And then my daddy was crying and put his gun away again. And then we went with the back into the jailhouse. My daddy, he was then strong. My mama was happy I let him go back since we all die in the jailhouse in there. Anyone let him go in the jailhouse, in the concentration camp, my daddy. While I all of them say, I'm in the army and fight for the land, and you do stuff to my family. So this was all.
Okay, we're going to stop the tape right here, okay?
Okay.
Tape 2, Ella Davis.
Yes.
Ella, we ended the last tape, but you mentioned you wanted to tell us something about your father.
Yeah, my daddy was had an instrument, and I played music in that. And my children was all the time happy when I was playing. Then was fun in the house. And my children started to dance.
And that was an accordion he played?
Yeah. And when you go to Auschwitz, they had a room in there, and there was gypsy people in there and play music for the Nazi. And my daddy was in there too. We got to please them. So my daddy was playing on a whole lot of gypsy people make music. They play good music, the gypsy people. With the, how you call it?
Violin. Bandolin.
Yeah. We had a little boy in Auschwitz. You crying when you hear that guy playing. Every time when they're playing, we always running to him and listen what they play. This was nice.
Okay, let's back up just a little bit. When did you realize that a war broke out? Did you know that before they picked you up?
No. But they picked us up there, but I was knowing that the war was breaking out. But we got to go every night in the cellar, in the cellar, and they throw bombs down. That's what this was. And there where I know the ball break out. And then in the morning my mama say, you know, can't buy nothing in the store no more. Then we heard from his mother. Myself, I don't know.
And How did the outbreak of the war affect your daily life? Do you remember what changed when the war started?
Yeah, we have to get up every night and run to the next keller, to the next cell. And my mama had a whole lot of little babies. So that was that you see that the wall was out. We run all the time with a little baby carriage to go in the keller before the houses got bombed. That's all.
How was the food situation at that time?
Oh, bad. You no could buy everything no more. They had a black market then. You gotta give something good, you get something good back.
And that's what your mother did?
Yeah. All the time. We had something pretty or something, then she went in the black market. And then you give that, you get that.
Did you go with her at any time?
No, I don't went with her then.
Did you all stay at home then?
Yeah.
Did you have freedom to walk around at all at that time? Or did your mama say no?
No, my mama said we not can go not outside. We got to stay in the room. So we stay in the room till she come back.
Were you ever taken away from your parents?
No.
Do you remember, were you and your family ever taken away from your town and put into a ghetto or a gypsy settlement?
No, we never went there.
And were you ever deported by train?
Yes, we did.
Okay, tell me about that.
Did they tell you when you go there and then they put you away? So we was 9 children, my father, my mother. We went in there. This was the last way when we went. So that's what it is. When you go the last way and you went in the train, you know you no came back no more. You could do what you want to. They can promise you, they promise you everything. They say we just stay a little while and then they take us to the back. Was not true. They lie. Everybody was lying and tell stories.
Where did you come from to go to the train? Was that from the jail?
Yes.
And tell me what the conditions were like on the train.
Oh, this was bad. They had trains where everybody go in just like cows. On the train where you sleep in there, sitting there. I was sleeping in top there. When you put your suitcase in top, there my children sleep in the train. So this was very bad.
How long were you on the train?
We was about 2 weeks on the train. Dina had no toilets, nothing. You have to do in the thing in there, in the train. Dina had nothing. They come by every 3 days, give you some to drink and some to eat, a piece of bread. So this was very bad. And I hope it's never happened no more.
Was your family able to take anything with them when they went?
Yes. Well, my one sister, my old sister Popla, she used to go, she supposed to go to communion. You know the first communion? And chips is very, very particular there. When you go, you got the best everything. And my mama packed that in. We took it with us, so we had a little while something to eat. Yeah. That, so I know that. I never forget that. Me hate from our grandmama cake and stuff food, smoking meat. We supposed to keep it for our little, for my sister. When she go the first communion. So my mama took everything with her. And we took it with in the train and there was she feed us. Well, you know, get nothing with soup in there.
And what else did your family take with them?
Oh, if you got money or jewelry, they take that. But they all the time need something to give, then you can receive. If you no give, you no receive nothing.
And they let you keep that when you got to
no,
the camp?
No, they take everything.
And what did you take? Did you take your bear with you?
Yeah, they took my bear. They took my bear and threw it to the clothes where I came in from the concentration camp.
So what was that like when you got to the concentration camp? What happened there?
There they put us, all we have to walk through. You have to put your clothes off, your shoes off. And they throw it all to the underclothes. And then we went in the under thing in there, like over here, under room in there. Then they cut your hair. And then you went in a long line. There would they give you the conjuration number. They know how much people they got. So much number you got in your arm, that much people they was in there. So that's all.
And which camp was this?
This was in Auschwitz. This was the biggest concentration camp where they killed people. And that's the only thing where you get that number.
And were you able to stay with your family at this time?
Yeah, with my mother. My daddy went to work camp. So
he was not with you in Auschwitz?
No, a couple weeks. And then they took him and put him in the thing. If you're not go, they get the gas. So I went.
So once you got to Auschwitz, did they put all of the gypsies in a special place?
Yeah, they was.
Was this called a gypsy camp?
Yeah, they use you for working. Gypsy got to work. They pull the dead people out.
Explain that.
We had eight stoves with long thing go up there. The eight stoves, the people, the gas them, give you a towel and a little bit soap and put you in there. People think, they come back out. They say, no, you got to take a bath. Most of people went in there were Jewish people. They gas them all. And then, when they gas them all, and then the gypsy have to come. People must touch each other and pulling each other. And they have to pull them apart. And then they put them in the bag up there, and then they drive them over there to the stove, and they have to put them in there and they brand them. And they were stinking, the dead flesh. It smelled very bad. So, after that was going everything. Was not so good. Some gypsy crying a whole lot, and they say, why they do that? They got no feelings for nobody no more. I feel bad for them little children who they hit on the wall, against the outside the wall.
What happened? What did they do?
They hit them against the wall and throw them in the fire in there and burn them. I see a whole lot of nighttime children. I never forget that. And this is bad. I tell my children all the time, when you go somewhere, bring the children here. I got them all the time here, over here. I'll be scared.
And what kinds of things happened to you and your family in Auschwitz? Tell me what life was like there.
Was it like hell? You could not do nothing. It was like hell. And you know, when you walk that street, you don't come out no more. You don't come out no more. You know that feelings you get when you see all that stuff was happening there. And you get the feelings, you don't come out no more. You can believe it. You don't come out no more. I don't know why I come out. I all the time say, when my brothers and people, my mama died and my father, I say, why I'm living still? I ask Jesus, I say, why I'm living still? I was not so good person. Why you not take me? I tell the people that, and they say, Ella, your time is not here yet. I got something planned for you. I say, what? I won't know that. No. That's what people tell me in that oldest home. It's just old people. Sometimes you sit there, you know, just wait for that you die. And that's very bad. So this was what happened.
So while you were in Auschwitz, you were with your family. Before your father was taken away, what kind of work did he do besides the ovens? Did he do other kind of work?
Yeah, working on the street.
Doing what?
Making a street that the people can walk by. Just fix a street. A whole lot of gypsies did that.
And did your father do anything else? Did he work in the kitchen at all?
No, I was in the cantine. You know what cantine is?
Mm-hmm.
The people buying stuff in there. And then my daddy was working in there.
In Auschwitz?
Yeah. We call it cantine. You can buy sauerkraut, mustard, stuff like that when you had some money left. When they don't find your money and take it away from you. Why they take but money and stuff, gold and stuff, they took it. And then people, well, they pull out of the stove, they had gold tea, they pull it out. They break the tea out and get the gold out. That's what Gypsy did too. My daddy, they have to do it too.
Did your daddy do any cooking for the Nazis at all?
No. No, and a cook.
And you said he entertained. He was part of the band.
Band, yeah.
Uh-huh. What were the food rations like?
Bad. You know, I had no food. They give you some food, some. What the cows eat, they make a soup out. And they give you that, they eat.
And did you do anything about that while you were there?
Yeah, steal. Like a rat.
What kinds of things?
I steal bread. I steal pots. If you not had a pot, you could not get no food. So I steal that and give it to somebody. And they give me a piece of bread for that they can get a ration. And when you not had no pot, you not can get your ration out. And I went out all the time by the Polish people, step in that pots while they was cooking, and then I pick them up and run. I did that. I all the time was somewhere where I'm supposed to be.
Did you ever get caught?
Yes. washed in the potatoes.
What happened?
Everybody went there and got the potatoes. I was the last one. Went over there and I got caught. And I had but 12 potatoes in my legs. And then while I was in there, somebody got me. So I put up, I said, I should get the potatoes out. So I got it out and put it on his desk. And then I get me some like cowl, whoop. The tail from the cowl. And this was standing in the water, and that is old water. And I have to count it, how many potatoes I ate. I had 12 potatoes. I got 12 times beat up. And then I asked me if I want them. I said yes. For my sister, she's dying, she's hungry. And then I got 12 more. I went home. I either could walk no more, or to lay in my back. I lay all of them in my stomach. My behind was open, where it would hit me. And then, I had them raw potatoes. I'm cook. Then we have to see how we cook it. Then they shoot you beside your head. Make sure you can cook them. So, this is a whole lot. A whole lot of suffering for something where you can get. I just hope that people heard that story, that they changed their mind. And do nobody harm. I wish, while all the time this, I had a wish, let people know what's going on in the world. And no listen, no promise. Just do your thing.
Tell me about the accommodations where you slept. How many people were in this place?
We had two beds. My whole family sleep in them two beds. No mattress, nothing. You sleep just in the floor.
And what kind of clothing did you have at this time?
I had clothing, but blue and white. A concentration camp clothes. They give you an address, and this is it. And a pair of shoes. And then in the nighttime, sometime they empty that building and get the people out and gas them. And when you gotta give your shoes away, you know you gotta get gas the next day. So they do that all the time.
And what were the sanitary conditions like? Where you went to the bathroom, cleaned up?
Oh, this was bad. This was really bad. When you go in the toilet in there, like I was a little girl, I rocked the whole night. Then I have to go out there. And then when I went out there, then you see all them dead people laying up out there. All kind of funny faces, like on eyes hanging out and stuff like that. And all skinny, just the bones and the skin. And every time I went out, I was thinking them people run behind me. Then I jump in a bed in there. I don't know who was laying down there. Sometime I wake up. He tells to my mama, pick up your girl. She sleep there. And I was laying by her dead people. That's what I did. While I was scared. And then the next hole where I see, I jump in there. And just laying in there with a dead person. and I was scared. Oh, that's what you do.
And how did you clean up? Did you have a place to wash up?
Yeah, a washing. There was left and right some cold water. You had no soap, you had nothing. All what the people did, get some sand and rub that with the wash you, like you got a piece of soap.
And did something happen to any members of your family there, like your brother? What happened there?
Not my brother, my sister was that. My sister, she was so pretty. And every time we sent her to get the ration, and then she came back, the ration was on top of her head, top of her clothes, and my children were always hungry. We took on the finger and did like that, and lick it up.
Why was it all over her clothes?
Why did not like her? She was too pretty. So I don't know. We not had no ration when she went there. And then she came back and we got mad, my children. Every time we sent you, we get nothing. It's very bad if people don't like you.
What did they do to her?
They cut her hair off. Make her look ugly. All that.
How did they make her look ugly?
They cut all her hair, bald headed. On beat her up. Burn her.
Burn her?
Yeah, burn her with that hot soup. And that thing where you pull, take it out, they put it on top of her head and face. And my children don't know nothing better. We lick that stuff up, the food, and eat it.
And what happened to your brother in Auschwitz?
My brother, nothing happened. He just there. He all the time helped me steal. My brother.
What about your little brother?
Oh, my little brother. This was like that. He was sick. And every night, the people come in and could put the chocolate milk down. And that man came in with his little pocketbook and put some poison in there. And my mama said to us children, you can drink water and let that chocolate milk for you, sick brother. So we listened to the mother. But she said, let's go. So we went there. Next day, the boy was dead, and a whole lot of children more. So we have to be thankful that I live because of that. A whole lot of children dies at night. While the chocolate milk was poison. Yeah, this was my little brother, Florian.
And what happened with your mother after she saw that?
Well, she's supposed to carry the boy down there to the other children who was dead. She could not do it. She was sick then. She was really sick. She could not believe it has happened then. And then later that man come all the time buy me something. Then my mama not let us eat no more. And me children got all mad. So that's what.
And did you go to school at all while you were there?
No. I never see a pencil or a piece of paper.
Did you have any oral education? Did anybody talk to you?
The nuns, yeah.
What did they tell you?
The nuns said that the war will be finished pretty soon. And we asked about that fire, that smell. And she said, Look at that smoke. Go straight to Jesus up there. They all be angels. That's what they teach us. They teach us out of the Bible. So. Our my children, my people, me not know that. They make us mad. They talk like that. Me looking for some the get out. And you talk about stuff like that. Yet everybody got their underbelief, no? Our them nuns, they was good people. They went outside, they could go outside and make him communist job and come back in. This was hard. You know what it was in there? And she still got to come back.
Did you speak German in the camp or did you speak Romani?
We speak Romani.
And were you able to communicate with anybody outside of your camp?
No.
Did you talk to any of the Jewish prisoners or anything like this?
Sometime we speak. You know, when they was coming by or the, like we stayed 3 days outside.
Okay, we're going to stop the tape right here.
Okay.
Ella Davis, tape 3. Ella, we ended the last tape. We were talking about your experiences in Auschwitz.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me, did you ever get sick while you were there?
No, I got abscess.
And what happened?
And I was sleeping the whole night with my arms up. I was in pain. And then I could not take it no more. Then I went, when we get up, and then I went to the place where the doctors was, and I went in there, and I show them, and I asked them if they can help me. They say, yeah. So, what he did, I have to put my arm up, and he got a knife, just cut it open, and then they push it out. So, that what? Well, I was by the doctor. You have to watch the doctors too in there. My little sister died in there. Maria. First she was laying in the middle. So long my daddy give up some smoke. She was laying in the front. And we're not giving us no more. She was laying all the way in the back in the toilet. When you lay in the toilet back there, you know you don't come out no more. So my daddy went in there and she was going. Then I look in the toilet back there, I found her. And she died then. So you got to watch, you have to watch them too. My mother was in there too. She had, I don't know how you say it, some kind of typhus.
Typhus, uh-huh.
Yeah, she had. And she was in there. And then a day before, she had some kind of feelings. She went out there. And in the night, the next night, they went there and emptied it. Emptied and gas all the people. My mama was lucky to go out. So, this was all the time something when you got luck. Oh, my mama was laying in there and they emptied the night time, the whole building, and gas them. When you was too sick, they gas you. So she went out. The next day, so she was okay.
Did you hear of any medical experiments going on?
Yeah.
Tell us about that.
The Else Koch, this was a big lady. She make out skin, clubs, and light, the light on clubs, hand clubs. She fix out skin from people. And then the Polish people, the under one. She got the big Polish people in there. They operate on the legs and took all that white stuff off the mark. Make an operation on the big ladies. That they not be strong enough. While the Polish people, these were strong women, like men. And there was one lady, and they want gas her. And she said, before I go, some people go with me. And she went closer and closer to a Nazi man and pulled a gun out from them. And she took 6 people with her. She told them, I could work by myself in there. I was some people go with me. And she shoot 6 Nazis. And then she went in there in the gas camera. Here. And then, when she went in there, they had paper coming back. They no post the gas or not. So, she was mad, but the gas said she supposed to help in the camp in there. Probably put the people in the gas, came and pull them in there. And he did that. I was like that. Experiment he did, he experiment on people. Like my mother, she had you know, one have no babies in there no more. They did some with some electro, but my mother could bring the legs. They did some, she could not have no babies no more. And then they promised us, when she let do that, then we came, she can take her children go out. So my mama was in there and told, well, I do let do that, then I come out with my children. They told a lie to her, with nothing. They did all kind of experiment in there. Just like them, how you call them queens. When you hate some, they kill them too. They say, they not smart enough. My divorced 2 babies.
Oh, twins?
Yeah, twins, yeah.
And what did they do to them?
They had a bus on top. They had gas in there. They let it in. And they drive from somewhere. And they die all. Yeah, they said they was not good, the twins. You had a pair. Did I kill you?
And what happened to you? Did they do something to you?
No. Oh, yes, you did something with me. I was with by myself and went somewhere. And then a Nazi came with a thing. With a gun, and on top of the gun was a knife in there. I hit my feet. I still got that mole in my feet.
How many times did he do this?
One time. I got one big thing there, scarf.
And why did he do that?
I don't know. I never had no choice to ask him why I do that. I guess I was mad.
What did you do? Did you do something?
No, I did nothing.
He just came up to you and did this?
I went then home. I was bleed very much. My mama broke her underwear and tied it up. That I know was so much blood.
Were you able to walk on it?
It was hurting. I was hurting with my feet a long time. And then we have to stay up 3 days, and this hurts. meet diese Appell, no? Then you have to come out and you read your number. And then you got to say here or there. Yeah. Then they see that you not took off. So that was what it was.
What was the treatment like by the guards and the capos?
Oh, then I was some people in there. What was good people, the Nazis, some. While I remember one man, he all the time bring him sandwich and throw the apple over the electric fence. And we children, we see it, and we run for. Our his friend, what was with him? He told him. So the next day, the man was hanging himself in the concentration camp. They hang him up while the man told on him. Ain't supposed to do that and not give us nothing. And the man say, "That's just children. They're hungry." And then I throw his food all over. Sometimes I bring more food like I'm supposed to bring and throw it over the fence. And my children know that. We run there and try to get it. Yeah. Was so. Sometimes people just came in there and you know can help it. You know can see everything dark. But some people help you. But some people not.
Do you remember seeing anybody trying to escape at all?
Yeah.
And what happened?
When somebody escaped, we have to stay in there because they bring them dead or the living. This is sometimes 8 days we stay outside in the cold. It's just like the army, you know, you go to call your number and you say, yeah. And then they say, you stay in there. Or some people get caught smoking. And we have to go on the floor and dray around in the stones and the dirt. We have to do that. And then they got it. And then when they got them living, bring them back, then they say, we can go in the inside, in the building in there.
And what happened when they found these people?
They kill them.
How did they kill them?
You put them in the gas camera. That's the easy thing. And then they gas them, and then they burn them. Or some they let people come together, and they hit a hole, and they shoot, and fall in the hole in there. Then they make fire. Yeah, that's bad.
Did your mother work while she was in the camp here?
Yes, she did.
And what did she do?
She helped over there to fix the streets.
Fixing the streets? And did you work?
I worked too, yeah.
What did you do?
I did. You know, like you set the grass in there? That's what I was doing. How you get a piece of bread more when you do that? We did that right there. We have to do it while the Hitler came.
Tell me about that.
I come and look through the barracks and outside around, see how it is, how it is everything okay. And then, when everything was okay, they take him with it to put him out. I had a car, drive him outside. We could not go close to him.
And who was this?
This was Hitler, the concentration camp.
You saw him?
Yes, I see him. I still got a picture of me, like I was.
Did he come into the gypsy camp?
Yeah. Jewish camp too. But we fixed all the camps outside. Put that grass mat down. and I was looking on the gypsy to fix the street. And when Hitler came, everything had to be nice and neat.
Can you think of anything else about Auschwitz that you want to tell us?
No.
And how long were you in Auschwitz?
3 years.
You were in Auschwitz for 3 years?
I was 3 years in the concentration camp. Might was all a little one there. I don't know how this works.
And so from Auschwitz, where did you go?
I went to Ravensbrück.
And how did you get there?
Morgen. Walk and go with the train a piece, and then we get out the train and was walking to the concentration camp, Ravensbrück. And there where you get rest, and they let you go in there. And I had a friend and a sister. Her sister was sick, and when you sick, walk and you could not walk no more, somebody came and shoot you and let you lay in the snow in there. So after that, she put her sister in her back and carried to the concentration camp in. So when we came in there, the lady no can come out no more, cannot get off her back. She was froze there.
She was frozen there?
Yeah, in her back. So we have to pull her down. Pull her down that she get off her back. That?
Was she still living?
Huh?
Was she still
living? No, she was dead. She died. She died then.
And in Ravensbrück, were you still with your family?
In Ravensbrück, my mama. They let my mama stay with us. Oh, not my daddy. I was in the concentration camp where I got to work. And my mama, she went in the morning. Work.
What kind of work?
On the street. Making that one street to the concentration camp in there.
In Ravensbrück, were the gypsies separated like in Auschwitz, or were they together with other people?
No, they was together with other people.
What types of people were there?
Oh, gypsies, German. People were no one walk outside. He was there.
And how did Ravensbrück differ from Auschwitz?
Ravensbrück was cleaner. That concentration camp was cleaner. Like the other one, you got no mattress, got nothing. They had mattress in there. They had sheets in the bed.
In Ravensbrück?
Yeah, in Ravensbrück. After greet me that. They had that in there. This was not all bad. While the gypsy took the sheets and the blanket off and so I'm scared. Don't I know that so good. And when we came in there, this was all be little white looking. It was cleaner. And we had Nazi women in there. They was meaner with the men's women. They was very mean. Beat you up with a stick. Like my mama was there, she used the restroom and she no could not go in there. She used it anyway. And then when she was using that, they catch her, they pull her out on the hair and beat her up with a stick. And then she have to stay in the washout 3 days. And was cold, snow and ice out there. So my mama was in there 3 days, standing there. She just had a baby, the smallest one, the last one, first. So that was what make her very sick. She had just a baby bring to the boy. She was standing out there in the thing.
She had the baby in Ravensbrück?
I think so. That's been told that it was in Ravensbrück. And she just had a baby. In Auschwitz and the concentration camp, she was there. And she was pregnant and had a baby. Tina could get the baby living. While they had a toilet, right, left and right. And when you was ready to get your baby, you have to sit on the toilet and let the baby fall down. That's what he did. So this was, my mama was lucky that she stayed 3 days in the water. While the girl made the baby about a half year, and then she starved to death and had this. She had no milk in there. And she, my mama drank the water from the drain to get milk, and that no help. And we had some gypsy women, who had babies too. And if you not give your bread to them, you give the bread, you let it drink the baby. If you not give it to you, use a ration, then they took it and put it on the floor, make you mad. You know, stuff like that, they make you mad and sad. Your own people, no? Your own people train rotten sometimes.
So the baby died after a couple of months?
Yeah, it died. She died. Was a little girl. She died. She was a pretty little girl.
And while you were in Ravensbrück, did you work?
Yeah, Kreis, work. And then you have to work, clean the hallway, stuff like that. Like that one lady, she had two little children. One was a Mitchell, one was a normal girl. And she was mean, the mother. She took all the food from the Mitchell away and gave it to the other daughter. And the Mitchell eat nothing. She still live in Regensburg, that girl. And she did. And the little girl, she had all the food from that little Mitchell. She died. She died. That one was she want help, she died then. The other one got no help, she living still. Still living. I see her one time in Regensburg. She talked to me, but I don't keep her no name in there. And I told her I just know that. And then she put the baby in her coat in there and put it in behind the locker. And when she got to clean the hallway, she see her coat. Her coat, she know her coat. Then she pulled the coat out, and the rats eat the whole girl.
How long were you in Ravensbrück?
I cannot tell you that. It was too much. So I cannot read and write, no? I cannot keep that all in my head. So I don't know it.
And did your mother have any clothes here, or was that a problem for her?
This was a problem. She was a big, healthy woman. So she had men clothes on, a men underwear. And I know like that. I say, Mama, I'll go get you a dress. And a lady was washing clothes and hang up a dress. And I see it. I went there and stole it and bring it home. Then I have to run that Dino catch me since they beat me up. And then I run and run one building in and another building out. And then when I run, I was laying, I was a blanket there. Somebody was laying there. I lay down and put a blanket over me. And they run weiter by me. So when they run by me, there was nobody running no more. I get up. When I look, was a dead lady down there. I was scared. I was very scared. So that's all I think.
Did they ever find out that you took the dress?
No. No. I pray for that. I was thinking the lady's here and know her dress. I all the time pray for that nobody find it out.
And what was the food situation there?
Oh, there was bad food. You don't got no food over there. If you don't help yourself, you don't get nothing. See, the Roma say I was a whole little gangster myself, either the concentration camp. If you don't did nothing, you don't get nothing. And I just try help my mama, my sisters, and my brothers. My one sister say she want red cabbage, cartoffel brei, and see her daddy, and then she like to die. See? And I was thinking that all the time when she say that, I did some that she got some.
How did you do that?
Go around and see, look around what they do now today. How many car coming with the potatoes and stuff. Then I was loose. Just like a dog, I was loose.
And did you ever run into any homosexuals at this time?
No, I didn't know them.
And where did you go from Ravensbrück? What happened next?
Mauthausen.
And how did you get there?
Walk again. We got to walk all the time. Oder die train, take uns mit der train one night and then they let you in the night time out. On the night time, they put you somewhere. They pick you up and then they work with you. Then they had dogs or Nazis watching you that you not can run off. If they see somebody run off, they shoot them. Let you lay in the side.
And did you see that happen?
Yeah, I see that.
Now, when you went to Mauthausen, how long did you walk? Do you remember how many days?
About 3 days.
And who of your family was still with you?
My mother, my brother, my sisters.
Was your older brother with you?
No, my older brother was gone.
Where did he go?
They put him to the men, where the men's was. They take them later, them young boys, and put them there.
Was he with your father?
Yeah.
And in Mauthausen, what were the conditions like there?
It was the same, like Auschwitz. Christina killed so much people there. Put them in the stove and all that. Kill them that much, not. They just you got to sit still and that they give you but the food now. This all.
Okay, we're going to stop the tape here.
Okay. I just wish my mother see that.
Ella Davis, tape 4. Ella, we were talking about your experiences in Mauthausen when we ended the last tape. Who were you housed with? Where did you sleep here? What was that like?
Sleep?
Mm-hmm.
In a bank, in a bed. They called it bunk.
A bunk?
Yeah.
And how many people to one bunk?
Six. We were six people.
And did you have any blankets here or anything like this?
No, they give us a blanket. They give you a blanket or no mattress, nothing like that.
And what was the food like here?
The food was very bad.
What kind of food did you get every day?
I get, you know what the cows eat? I don't know how you say that. And over here they feed the peas, the sweet peas. Where you make sugar out, that's what they cook with for soup. And every 8 days you get a piece of bread, something like you 8 days. And this was it.
And who all did you live with here? Who was in the barracks with you?
In the barracks, a whole lot of people.
What types of people?
There was gypsies, a whole lot. There was Jewish people, some in there. There was people in there, but we just don't know it. There was a little boy, what I like, in there. So, was everything in there. And later, you know, later after a while, you know him then. And you talk to him.
And go ahead.
I was never seen her sex valley. I never see them.
Never saw what?
How you say sex valley? Homie.
Oh, homosexuals.
Yeah. I never see them.
And tell me about this little boy. Did you play with him while you were there?
This the little boy? I play geig. Drum I know him so good. I play music. So all the time I was around him.
What kind of music did he play?
I had a violin. And then when I had it, and then they say, they go get him. And I had a sister. And his sister say, you don't have to work by yourself in there. And then the sister went with him in there by herself on that little boy. And the boat was there then. While they look strong people, you live in there. Our people who were sick, and they take them and put you in there. So the boy was okay. Was dead with some same sister.
And were any members of your family sick at this time?
My mama, yeah. Oh, my mama came out a day before. She supposed to get gassed. She went away. She had locked. She went out that building. She just DDM the buildings in the night. They had all kind of people, sick people in there. And then they didn't know what they do with them. And then in the night they emptied that building and gas. And then you was going, nobody know where you went.
Now in Mauthausen, what were the sanitary conditions like there? Do you remember?
No.
Okay. From Mauthausen, where did you go?
Mauthausen, little boy, Geheide.
And tell me about that camp. What was that like?
This most of the camp is the same. You got to watch yourself that you don't get killed. And look what you get, some food extra. Or do you not come out?
And how did you get extra food there?
You have to steal. You have to walk around.
And did anybody in your family steal besides you?
My brother, yeah. Me and him was all the time in the nighttime. We get in dark. We was on the street. And the concentration camp and go around. She was going on. Yeah, If you don't do that, you don't live. Like a lady had a couple soaps, I got them soaps. I no wash me no more with sand. I did that. I mean, it's bad to say it. You steal from the under person who got nothing either. But I did. Really. If you don't do that, you was lost. When you did it, you help yourself. And I was the one to help myself for my sisters and brother and my mother. I helped myself. I mean, it's not nice to say it, you know, how I did.
And when you were in this camp, again, was it a mix of people or was it only gypsies here?
No, it was mixed people.
And did people work here?
Yeah, he was working.
Was there a factory nearby they worked at?
No.
I thought you had mentioned that there was a factory.
There was a factory already making bombs and guns. He did that, yeah.
And people who, inmates, prisoners, yeah. They did this?
Prisoners they put over there. They went in the morning out, the night they walked back.
And did your mother work at this?
My mama did too, yeah. Oh, my auntie did it with her 16 children.
Tell me what happened to her.
Bimp. She had 16 children, 16 cousins and nieces. And she had hairpins on the floor down. And they didn't like that. They cut all her hair off. And then she said to my mama, she no come out no more. She wore herself to death, make her hair. Then she died too.
And what about the children? What happened to all of the children?
The children. She had a whole lot of children. The father, he took the ration. He took the ration.
From the children?
Yeah, and eat it. And my mama got mad. My mama cussed him out all the time. I eat it anyway. So the children had no food.
And what happened?
Huh?
Did any of them survive?
Two, a man and a girl. These here too, over there. Macho. Name's that name.
And from Lilleberg, Haida, where did you go then?
Auschwitz, Ravensbrück, Mordhausen, Lilleburg Heide was the last one, I think.
Were you ever in Bergen-Belsen?
Bergen-Belsen, yeah, this was the last one.
And how did you get there?
Walk to. Me was marching.
And what
and was... all the time borders green dead. Me have to walk there.
And what was the weather like at this time?
Cold.
And when you got to Bergen-Belsen, what was it like there?
We had a whole lot of snow all the time.
Did you have anything to keep you warm?
The clothes were you got here.
Was that enough to keep you warm?
No, but you try to keep yourself warm.
And how many of your family made it to Bergen-Belsen with you? Besides you and your mama, who else made it there?
My sister and my brother.
Which sister, which brother?
Popla and Horst, them two, and me, myself. And the rest, 37 people died from me.
From your family?
Yeah. My dad, my aunt, my dad, my cousins and nephew, No, my cousins there, and boys. We was all there. And was there the seventh of my family who died there. And there's really a whole lot of people there, the seven.
And describe the day when you knew the war had ended.
Was ended, the English people was driving around with the airplane, and then they throw paper out and told us we should stay another couple days, hold on, we'd be free.
They had paper coming from
coming down from the airplane. They throw it down. And they say that we shall hold it off for a little while. We could be free. That was.
And how did people react when they?
Oh, they react crazy.
What happened?
And then the American came in and feed us food. And this was too crazy. Then more people die. But you have to start with them people like little babies.
And what happened with your family? Who were you with when the Americans came in?
With my mother was.
And how did you not get sick with food? What happened to you?
We not eat everything. My mama did that. She gave us just a little bit there, a little bit there. She not let us eat everything.
So she was pretty smart, huh?
Yes, she was a smart lady.
And what was the date of liberation? Do you remember? When they came in?
No, I don't know.
How old were you?
I was about 11.
And where did you go after the war ended?
Looking for my daddy.
So where did
you? To my granddaddy.
And where was that?
It was in Stuttgart. So we found his daddy over there.
Was your brother there too?
Yeah.
No, the one that went with your father?
Yeah, I was there. I came together with them.
So out of your immediate family?
Came five people out.
Your mother and your father?
Me and my sister and my brother.
And did you stay with your grandparents at this time?
Yeah, didn't let them go. We have to stay there.
And how long did you stay there?
We stayed there about 4 months.
And what was that like at this time?
It was nice. Our, you know, you still worry about you get a place for your own. My mama was worried about.
And how did the neighbors react to you when you came back?
Oh, they came back. They was happy. Not much people came back.
And did you have any problems right away after that with people?
No, the school. I had problems with the school. While I never learned, I was all the time sleeping.
Why were you sleeping?
I don't know. Probably tired.
Did anybody in the school give you a hard time?
No.
How did you learn of the rest of the family? What happened to the rest of the family?
The rest of the family, nothing.
How did you find out what happened?
How I find out? I was there when he died all the time. When my sister dies. My daddy was surprised that my mom and I brought nobody with us, three children. He left me the whole lot of children. My mom left me the whole lot of children. And my daddy was, would I all the time asked my mom would and the children. And then she told him she did. He was surprised.
And did you encounter any discrimination after the war? Did anybody give your family a hard time
They give me a hard time.
What happened?
They see my number on some mean people. They say, I just touch a salad. You know, when you got a hot salad, you got a whole lot of salad. So I touch it. And then the men say, they forgot you the gas, but why had to touch all the salad? I say, well, I want a good one. And they say, they forgot you the gas.
And what did you say?
I say, no, they forget you. Yeah, me still got them people on. And the Roma said, people still know what's going on.
Was your family given any aid after the war? Did anybody help your family to get back on their feet?
No.
And what did you and your family do after the war? Did you?
Me selling brochures.
And your father, what did he do?
He buy and sell.
And after
all the gypsy do that.
And after you left your grandparents, where did your family go?
We bought in a trailer house.
A trailer house?
Yeah.
And where was that?
In Stuttgart.
And so your family moved into that?
Yeah.
And then what did you do?
I do nothing.
Did you work at that time?
Yeah, I sell. Help my people.
And did anybody ever ask you about your experiences?
No.
Did you ever tell people about them?
Yeah, I did.
Tell us about that.
You know, the last time they took a little boy from me away over here, one of my grandson, and the DS, or how you call it, I told them, I say, now you worry about children, but you worry about us. I say, you know what's worry about them. You know what's worry about us. Now you're taking children away from the people. Well, the children got it good. And middle of the courthouse, I say, no way. You don't mess with me like that. I say, I was in there. All the children, people die in there. Where you was? You helped somebody. Daddy need help. I get mad then, you know.
Was this in Germany?
No, over here.
In the States?
Yeah. I got really mad. You know, they taking people's children away and just make a big deal out. You cannot be with them, the children beat the children up with them. So I told her, I scared up, and I didn't even know what I'm talking about. Because my husband explained it to her. I got mad. I said, well, yes, was. People from thousand children died, starved to death. Well, you was? You help? No. Oh, here make a thing out something, but it's not either voice. I tell him that.
Let's go back to after the war. How long did you live with your parents? Until you were how old?
I was 17 years, and then I left.
And where did you go?
I went to my granddaddy.
Which, your father's?
Your father.
And what happened then?
I stayed there.
For how long?
For 2 years.
And did you work at this time?
Yes, I did the same thing.
And then where did you go?
Nowhere. I was all the time there.
And did you ever speak at any of the schools here in the United States?
No. In Mannheim, I speak.
One high school?
Yeah.
When was that?
You could say about 5 years gone.
About 1993?
Yeah, I talked to the children. And then I was talking to a bunch of people who belong to the church, 500. I speak there.
Which church was this?
Christian church. I still got picture where they make picture of me. They give me flowers. And then I talk to them.
And how have your experiences affected the way you've lived your life or brought up your children? How do you think that?
You know what? My daughter brought me of that. You know, well, I was in there. That go on. I get mad so bad that you do your children the same way, like you are in the concentration camp. You know, it's so mean. My Belinda told me that, Mama, you was that way. You wait. You play soldier with us, army. So I say, well, I play with you. Yeah, you take the meanness out of us. You tell us me, you are mean. You know, this was is yeah, it's a train mean sometimes. So I don't know.
And how has life changed for the Roma and the Sinti since you were a child?
Oh, they changed a whole lot.
In what ways?
In what ways? They not talk about nothing. They scare. And I don't believe in scareness. I was in there. I was scared. This was it. The people supposed to know it was going on. Nobody scared. Talk up. You supposed to talk up. We never did nothing. He never talk about them people. Drum this goes so easy way. Nobody say nothing, nobody want nothing to do with that. I say, you was there too. I try, there's one gypsy in the States will go around and tell them people that stuff. I remember that. I just not his name.
Where and how did you meet your husband?
My husband, through the telephone.
How did you meet him through the phone?
I called for a friend, and every time when I called, my husband was there. I said, golly, you know, got nothing else to stay in the telephone. And that's the way I met him.
And where was this?
This was in Mannheim. My daughter's 24 years old, so it's 24 years. I'm married 26.
And what kind of work was he doing in Germany?
He was in the army.
So you met him while he was in the army?
Yeah.
And how many children did you have before that?
Three.
Before you married?
Yeah.
And how many children do you have now?
I got 7.
And when did you get married? Do you remember the date?
72, I think.
And when did you come to America?
I've been here 10 years now.
And how did your life change when you came here from Germany?
Oh, different. Everything is different over here. I get homesick sometimes. I want to go back. I would then think about how mean they are over there. Then I say to myself, I'm better here with over there. By the people go around, eating people and all that. It's not good over there.
Do you still know gypsies who are over there?
Yeah.
Who's over there?
There's some gypsies. I got to find the names.
Any family still there?
My one brother.
And what's life like for him there?
I don't know. Anna asked him. They all come over here, they say this look is bad over there. Say that they make that wall away. All the Nazis work back in here in Germany.
Did you have any problems before you came over here?
Yes, I had.
What happened?
I buy a salad and the man told me, they forget you the gas. So that's what it is.
And when you were married in Germany, did you have problems there?
No. I had no problems.
And how does the community here treat you?
This bad.
Here in America?
Yeah. They never say nothing. I don't think they like me around here. They don't say nothing. They don't do nothing. They don't say hello. They say nothing. You can see the Google glance. They act like that. So, I don't worry about Anna live of them. So, I don't want nothing from them. They want nothing from me. I let them live.
Have you made some good friends here in the United States?
No. One, yes. One.
And do people here know that you are a gypsy?
I tell them. I tell them I'm a gypsy woman.
And what is it like here for you as a gypsy?
The all what they think they steal. And that is all what they no steal no more. They probably do, or I don't know. I don't do it, so I don't worry about it.
And what is your religion today?
Mormon.
And how did that happen?
How did that happen? Oh, me and my husband all the time go that way to the church and that way. So I met two old people and they showed me that Mormon supposed to be a good church. So I tell you the truth, I think so too.
You like being a Mormon?
Yeah, I think so. They are good. They really are good. That's not bad. If you got trouble, you go there and tell them. They help you.
Okay. Do you have any political affiliation here?
No.
Okay. We're going to stop the tape here.
Okay.
Ella Davis, tape 5. Ella, we were talking about your experiences since you're over here in the United States. Do you have any dreams about your experiences?
Yes, I do.
Tell me about those.
You know, when you sleep and you think about your sisters and brothers and then you dream about them. And that may bother you. And I don't want to sleep all the time. Eating sleeping pills. So I leave that alone. So I still dream about my people. And about them. About my brothers and sisters.
Have you told your experiences to your children?
A little bit. I tell them when they don't want to eat. I say, in the time, we was happy to get something to eat. And he won't throw it away, and you know, stuff like that, I come out with.
But you never told them the whole story?
No, this is the first time.
How come?
I don't want my children to know all that. They probably think something else.
How do you think they'll feel now about hearing about it?
Oh, they like it.
They want to know.
Yeah.
What are your views today in America about tolerance and racism? What do you think here?
This is bad, all that. This is really bad. They're not supposed to do that no more. Especially the black people.
You mean against the black
people? Yeah. This is bad. Because they have the same right like the white people. Our Dino got it. Our like I say, it's not my problem, not my business. Our then I think about it's my business. I got black children and a black husband. So you gotta be that way too.
And how do you feel about your experiences here versus your experiences in Germany?
In Germany, it's ever this your town where you come from, you feel better. Over here, this is a town where you know nothing about. You feel better.
And how many children and grandchildren do you have now?
I got 23 grandchildren and 7 children.
And do they mostly live in this area?
Yes, they all live around me. I don't want to lose them, not. I want to hold on what I got. Through I came to America. I had my son here and my one daughter. And I say, I'm going back there to my children. And through I got married and came here.
And now, over 50 years later, what message or lesson would you like your children or your grandchildren to learn from your experiences?
Just you know, make the same mistakes, not what the other people do. Respect the people. Everybody got a heart inside, so respect them.
And if you had one thing that you wanted people to remember from all of your experiences, what would that one thing be?
That one thing be that they should treat the people better. If you know can treat them better, leave them alone.
Is there anything else that you would like to cover that we have not covered yet?
No, I just want that people learn out that story, something.
And how are the gypsies today? What do they do today?
They do what other people do, find a job, a good one, sell, like I did. There's a gamble, you know, a gamble, when you gamble, you get some, sometimes not.
So you think that the gypsies pretty much are more settled today than when you were a child?
Yeah. Well, you know, the gypsies, they're scared. They're really scared, them people. That's happened to them, and they're scared now. They don't open the mouth, not fight for that, what they need, what they get, what they need.
And should they?
Yeah, they should do it. You know, see the Jewish people, no fight for, they fight for what they want.
And you'd like to see that happen for
yeah,
the
to the gypsy the same way. Stick together and fight. Do it.
Ella, thank you for letting us interview
okay.
you today.
Okay, thank you.
Ella, could you tell us what your number is?
My number was, so many people was in there already.
And what is the number?
The number is 59, 37. And that C stands for Gypsy.
Which is what in German?
Zigeuner.
Thank you. Ella, who is this a picture
this
of?
This my father.
And his name?
Alvin Wittig.
And approximately what year was this picture taken?
Oh, I don't know that.
How old do you think he was here?
About 50-some.
So he was born in 1912. And where was this picture taken?
Oh, I don't know either.
Was it in Germany?
Yes, in Germany. Oh, yeah, I know it. I had a little picture and I went to a photograph and they make me a big picture like that in Heilbronn.
Okay. Ella, who is this a picture of?
This is my mama. Her name is Sophie Birkefelder.
And then? When she married your father, it was...
Wittig.
And approximately what year was this taken?
Well, she was but 60.
So around the mid-80s?
Yeah.
And where was this taken?
In Germany.
Okay.
And then
and who is this a picture of?
This is my brother, Horst Alwin Wittig.
And what was the date of this photo?
Oh, about 54.
And where was it taken?
In Stuttgart. This is my oldest daughter. Myself.
And your
Ella
name?
Davis.
And her name?
And she's Moody Wittig.
And what was the date of this photo?
About 54.
And where was it taken?
In Stuttgart.
Germany?
Germany, yeah.
Ella, who is this a picture of?
This is my oldest daughter.
Your second?
Yeah, the second one. No, the first one.
This is the first one. What's her name?
Linda.
And her last name?
Oh, I don't know her last name.
And when was this taken?
In 54, too.
Okay. And where?
In Germany.
Okay. And Ella, who is this one?
This is my third one.
And her name?
Bobby Rosario.
And what year was this taken in?
Oh, probably 66.
And where was it taken?
In Kitzingen.
Germany?
Germany, yeah.
And who is this a picture of?
This Belinda.
And her last name?
Gilmore.
And when was this taken?
See. 64 too.
And where was it taken?
In Kitzingen.
Germany.
Germany. Direction.
When was this picture taken?
In 67.
No, in the late 70s?
Late 70s. And her name is Belinda Gilmore. In Germany. This is Donald Wittig on the picture take 70.
In the late 70s?
In late 70s.
And where was it taken?
In Germany.
In Kitzingen?
Kitzingen, yeah. This my husband and zwei kleine Kinder.
And your husband's name is?
Curtis Davis.
And your daughter's name?
Pamela Davis and Curtis Davis.
The little boy is?
Curtis Davis too.
Junior.
Yeah, junior.
And what year was this taken?
81.
And where was this taken?
In Fort Hood.
In Texas?
Texas.
In the United States?
Yes. This is my family.
My name's Diana Rosario. And my mom, she raised us. We learned a lot from her about her experience she had in the concentration camp. She went to our school, told us about it, and it touched us a lot.
My name is Belinda Gilmore. I love my mom very much, and she's a very special gypsy.
My name is Pamela Davis. My mom's experiences have taught us to be more caring people, I believe. We pay more attention to the other side of people's thoughts and feelings. And I love her a lot. I'm glad she's my mom.
My name is Curtis Augusta Davis, Jr. My mom taught us a lot growing up. She taught us to be thankful for the time we've grown up. And I felt real bad that she had to suffer for what she went through. And I always love her.
Okay, Curtis Davis, I'm father of this wonderful group of grandfather. And this is my wife here. We've been married for 23 years. Been together for about 26 years. And she taught me a whole lot, and she's the best mother and a wife a person can have.